Okay, Aki Kareem, British boxers, we're here today at Fight Factory in Manchester. Sean Crew, we've got your whole squad with us here today, haven't we?
Yep.
Do you want to sort of just take us down the line? Because I've met a few of the boys.
Okay, so what will do you know, Sean?
Yeah.
And then we'll hand over to Paulie De Silva, and Paulie will take it from there.
Paulie, new man in the team yourself?
New man in the team, yes.
Tell us about sort of how this happened and, you know, when you started working with Sean and all that sort of stuff?
We started working from, it was beginning of December.
Yeah.
Not start working, I moved there.
Yeah.
And then we sat down, we planned things, and then we got on. Then I seen what Sean's got here, the setup he's got here. And one thing lead to another thing. I thought it was a good idea for a fresh start, to get a group of raw kids I can work on and build it up, and get back into the boxing scene again from scratch. So I managed to get, then we're going to have lads that are going to be on the road, but going to win some, lose some, and then I've got a bunch of raw talent that I'm going to be working on. Is in my head, it's a five-year plan. We're only in the second month of hard working, and it will be fun, because I can see the potential in every single one of them. They do listen, and with the facilities that we've got, you just can't go wrong.
Tell us a little, introduce everyone for us then. You know, I know some of the lads, but tell us about, you know, who all the lads are then.
So I've got Logan, who's 19, Logan?
20.
20. Logan is 20, yet four amateur fights. But me personally, he's still got a lot till he go back into the ring. So he's got four fights. To me, he's raw, a lot of work on, a lot of potential, natural strength. We got Vincent, just turned 15, 94 kg. Yeah. So he's gonna be.
Well,
and this kid got some serious power. He's got some serious, even he doesn't know how hard he hits.
Yeah.
So it's, again, big potential. Got Josh, that we go back when I first came to UK with his family. So Josh, I will do the same what I've done with Maru. In a year's time, you're gonna hear about Josh. Now he's just like breaking down. Got Kumi, there we go back a long time. Kumi doesn't have amateur style at all.
No.
But there's a lot of things that I personally think that he needs to work on, and he will do well on his own time, then he will see where his career will take. And Super Mario, that you know well.
Yeah.
A bit full of himself at the moment. again, he's 1 year this month when I start boxing. He's doing very well. He's learning. He's listening. We got Joseph from Hungary. They came to us, Joseph and Benny. I can talk with them both at the same time. Came to me. Wanted to do some boxing and earn a living. So fortunately, Sean provided for facilities for them to stay over. So they were living in Blackpool. Now they're living in Manchester, one of Sean's apartments. Now they're training twice a day, living and breathing boxing. This man already lost 12 kilos in 3 weeks.
Yep.
Well so done. He's on the right way.
And Joseph's had one pro fight.
And, yeah, Joseph has one, but it's been more than him. And these two, it's going to be, they're going to win some, lose some, but the way we're doing things, they will look after themselves. And then we got Sean Farrell, that you know well. He's fighting on the 16th of March. That is working under the guidance of Sean Crew. Occasionally when Sean needs, because he's busy doing something, I'll do some work with Sean. This is the factory team, the factory ABC.
That's right. But it's more than ABC, it's like ABC to Z now, isn't it? It's like you've got your own little crew there.
Yeah.
So Sean, I mean, it's you've always had an international sort of camp.
Yes.
It's got even more international.
It's more international now, yeah. Yeah, we Paulie and I go back many, many years.
15 years,
with Wayne Barker. We both, when Paulie was boxing, I was helping Wayne in the gym. So I go back a long time with Paulie. And who was with you there, Paulie?
Monty,
yeah. So yeah, when Paulie came to me and spoke to me about plans that he wants to go forward and do his own thing and especially establish his amateur boxing club, I said, why not? And we know each other for many years, so it wasn't, it wasn't anything difficult to us sitting down and planning to move forward and doing what we're doing. And we've got an enthusiastic bunch of young lads that want to do their thing too. And we know we've got a blank canvas, so the Fight Factory can, the people hear about us. Especially once Paulie gets the team going, I'm happy it's someone like Paulie because we need a good amateur team. It's only natural way to move. You have your amateurs and you have your pros. So I think it's a no-brainer. Mm. So moving forward, we know under the guidance of Paulie, and if you have a hungry bunch of lads, it's only one way forward, and that's all the way to the top.
Let's find out a little bit about the lads then. Who's the hardest, who's the fittest guy in here?
I think he wants to take the crown.
Not fastest, but when it comes to stamina or lasting long, I think I am at the moment. Well, when it comes to the amateurs, yeah, but at the moment it's Sean, but when it comes to the amateurs, it's us.
No, you got to give it to Sean. Yeah, Sean is on the top of the tree. As in look-wise, I think I'm the fittest.
Oh, look good. Oh, so you think you're the best looking? Yeah. That's right, with the slick back hair.
By far.
Who's had the most fights, just interestingly? You know, amateur, pro, or whatever, white collar, whatever, all together, who's had the most?
It's funny enough, because they all have the same.
Right.
Four fights.
Yeah.
Four fights.
Right.
Three fights. So they're all on the same level. This is the beauty of it. Mm. They're all on the same level. They're not better than each other. So the way I'm planning, on the novices, I can see future national champions. And every single one of them, not taking no one away. Every single one of them
in this weight division,
they're all different weights.
Yeah.
They all can be national champions. No reason why. And the way we are training, the way I'm drilling on that, and their mindset, it's just one way forward with these amateurs.
Mm.
And the way I'm planning with them is, so we're not just gonna let anyone come in and train. So it's got to be something about that person.
Yeah.
And then if I can't see nothing, if I can't see future on them in a way, I give them, like I told Kumi, I give you 2 weeks, show me what you've got, and I say yes or no. And then if I don't feel like it should, we got the classes, the kit fit classes at the separate times, they can come in and join it. It's enjoyable, it's fun. It's busy that they can join and do their boxing, but when it comes to the team, it's got to be something about them for me to work with. I've got to see some kind of future, and it's not just them in the gym training. It's what they're doing outside, it does matter to me, because sometimes the outside will affect the inside. So everything's got to be right.
Yeah, and you mentioned to me earlier, you've got some family ties in boxing already with Ophi, Zach and the Burtons as well. So is that adding pressure, or is that just a good thing, another resource you can go back to, you know, get some extra advice?
Also, you know, Yui.
I know Yui well, yeah.
And he's my first cousin as well.
Yeah.
So yeah, surrounded by it. All my family's into the boxing and that. A lot of my cousins. As you say, Jose Burton, he's a very good professional. He's up there with us. And my other cousin Zach, he was doing a bit, but I'm not too sure what his plans are now. But yeah, all bred into it, really.
Yeah, yeah.
Got the pedigree.
You got the pedigree, that's it. Yeah, I was speaking to Yui last week, actually, yeah, in his new camp. Wait, and you got two boys from, is it Hungary?
Yeah.
Does anyone here speak Hungarian then? You speak a bit of English?
English, yes.
How have you lost that much weight? What have you been doing to lose the weight?
Boxing.
Just boxing, yeah.
Training, eating.
Here, UK.
No.
Manchester.
How did you lost all this weight? So you're the weight that you lost?
Yeah. 66. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's where you want to be
at the moment.
So has Paulie been good or has he been bad?
Good,
he's been using
good.
The whip.
Oh yeah. Listen, that's for another show. This is a family show, this show.
Inside good, outside don't look no good.
Did you prefer Blackpool or Hungary?
Yeah. Blackpool.
Yeah.
Blackpool.
Right, I think you got that one, didn't you? Yeah.
But Manchester's better than Blackpool. Yeah, Manchester
is better, Blackpool is no good weather.
Okay, I might edit that bit out just in case. We've got a lot of people who watch this from Blackpool, so I might. So, everything's going good? Everything's going really good with the camp?
Yeah, definitely.
We keep on
building, don't we? You just got to keep on building. Someone once gave me this analogy, said, when you're working your way up to the top, ride on a donkey instead of a Ferrari, because when you're doing it slow and steady, you can see all the pitfalls. When you're whizzing past in a Ferrari, coming back down, it's difficult. You don't know, you've been moving that fast, but you can't see all the pitfalls. So we're on our donkey, all the way to the top. It'll take us time, but we're working.
You've always got a new catchphrase for me. I like that. Just tell us finally then, when can we see all the boys out, or if they've not got a date in mind, potential dates of when all the boys might be out, or, you know, in their careers?
So our thing now, Sean's out next on the 15th of March, and obviously Paul and I do everything together. And then we're just waiting for a inspection from the amateur boxing board.
Yeah.
And then as soon as that's done, the boys are ready to fight. I mean, Paulie's got him in here thrice a week. And Maru comes during the day too. So we're ready to go. And once we registered as a club, they'll be fighting every week, won't they?
Yeah.
They'll be fighting regularly.
They'll be fighting every week almost. So.
Right, so that's what you need, isn't it? All the boys out fighting regularly.
Yeah. I'm waiting for our Hungarian lads' licenses. We're getting them sorted out with the board, and then again potential fights with probably different promoters and managers contacting us for them to go on shows. Yes.
Nice. Right, final one. Then I'm going to go down the line, and I want your favourite fighter of all time.
Mine would have to be Felix Trinidad.
Marvin Hagler.
Lobachenko.
Mine would have to be Roy Jones Jr.
It's gotta be Rocky Marciano. James Toney.
Mike Tyson.
Ali, Muhammad Ali.
Sugar Ray Leonard, my man right there.
But too much, the fighter is good.
Sugar Ray Robinson.
Yeah. Henry Armstrong. Right, okay boys, it's been a pleasure. Good luck to all of you, and we'll come down and see you all soon again. Yeah, cheers boys.
Cheers, thank you.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion, and also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.